This is Tim Guy.
Hey, I'm
wave,
here.
Wave to the people.
Oh, hey.
You're adoring public.
Which
this is welcome to This Week in American Idol. We're a little frazzled this week, I'll be honest with you, because we are about to head out to the Coachella Valley Music and Arts Festival, where you can check out our coverage all weekend, PE.com. It's going to be awesome. But I'm a little bit like, last night, I can't tell like if last night didn't make sense to me on Idol because I was so tired, or if it was because it was just not a, it was a weird night.
Well, you could kind of zone out. I had to work it.
By the way, great. Thank you for blogging. Your blogs crack me up. We're going to get to some of those later.
Okay.
Yeah, no, because they were good.
Okay.
I'm giving you a compliment. Why can't you ever, like, just take the compliment?
The way you give compliments scares me sometimes.
Ouch.
You're a nice person! I'm like, okay.
It's because I want to be in a metal band. Okay. You're a nice person!
We'll get to metal in a little bit.
Oh, we totally will. We're going to talk about metal.
Yes.
We're going to talk about jazz. We're going to talk about pop. We're going to talk about some...
country.
Well, we always talk
faux
about
country.
And a really bad rendition of a Blondie song. So let's go get it started. Lauren Elena.
Lauren Elena.
Sing.
Of all the movies in all the world.
Okay, well, yeah, I guess we have to explain that. Last night, songs from movies.
Yes. Which has always been the worst theme.
Really? I think Disco Night's the worst theme.
They just pick a song. Because if you really think about it, most popular songs or well-known good songs have been in a movie. So you could say, like, oh, I loved, you know... Oh, I didn't know Boomerang had this song in it. Of course.
Okay, no, I knew that one, but we'll get to that. Okay. I knew that in Boomerang. And you know what? Coming up, you know, Neon Trees, our local band, playing Coachella Sunday night. They're going to have their new single, Your Surrenders, in the upcoming Disney Prom movie. So maybe next year, someone will sing Neon Trees on movie night.
Okay, so back to Laura and Elena.
Okay, tell them what movie she
Of
picked.
All the movies in the world, she picks the Hannah Montana movie.
I thought it was a joke. I, like, just busted out laughing. And I was like, at least she didn't pick Country Strong.
Well, I was afraid for a second that Scotty would pick Country Strong. But, so Lauren picked The Climb by Miley Cyrus. But what I thought was really cool, and I guess in some ways it's kind of obvious, but Jimmy Iovine said that she's a stronger singer than Miley Cyrus.
Yeah, I was
that
like...
that was nice, and I thought, well, that's kind of obvious, but...
Yeah, but and she was just like flabbergasted by it. And Will.i.am was back this week, too. Which she was hilarious. I was like, I want you to be on the show more, because you're...
Get rid of Steven Tyler and just put Will.i.am on there.
No, I like Steven Tyler.
Well, Will.i.am is not sexually harassing people.
Did he sexually harass anyone last... Because I started
yeah,
skipping...
Haley.
Oh, did he? I started skipping through the judges' comments because I was like, you're not saying anything constructive.
No, he...
So I just fast-forwarded.
He got Haley.
Oh, wow. But Lauren did The Climb.
Yes. And like I said in my blog, I actually saw Miley Cyrus perform that song live.
Yes, you did.
And thought it was okay. Like, I'm like, oh, okay. My friend hated it. She said it was out of tune and everything. But I thought Lauren did a great job of it. Wasn't really...
Your friend hated the Miley Cyrus one or the Lauren one? Oh,
no,
okay.
The Miley Cyrus one. I thought the first half of the song... Was great.
Were you waiting for the climax? Because I just kept waiting for that punch, for that climb to take me over the edge.
No, I was waiting for the country to slip in, which it kind of did towards the end.
Okay.
But I don't mind that because unlike some other country people, she could try
Scotty.
She could try different things. So.
Yes. Well, because she's the next Carrie Underwood.
So I put her number three on my list for...
Well, we'll get to the rankings.
Okay.
We'll get to it. Well, you always do the rankings at the end. You're throwing me off.
Okay, I'm sorry.
But,
I'm getting mixed signals
her.
Here.
I liked her, but then we got to talk about Haley. Speaking of people
Do we
who
have
are
to?
Well, we're not Haley fans. We've said this.
I've tried to give her a chance.
And I actually didn't
over
hate
over
last week's Piece of My Heart. But I don't
I
understand
did.
How she's still there. And your girl Pia is not. Oh, we even talk about that. Pia's gone.
I don't know.
You're sad. She already has a record deal, though.
Yeah, that's true. But can we just say straight up? I mean, let's just not even mince words. Because unlike the American Idol judges, we can actually give criticism.
Okay, Haley sang Call Me from Blondie, from the movie. I also thought it was great. I was like, she picked Call Me from American Girl. It's like, it's a family show, and she picks the song.
She only did that because it's like, what movie was Call Me in?
Yeah, I
Let's
know.
Let's see.
But
oh,
it was
okay.
actually like a pretty, I mean, that's pretty well, I think that's when it topped the charts was when it was in that movie. I think that movie helped make, I mean, because there is an actual tie with that movie, though,
okay.
as opposed to some of these other tangential movies.
Well, her performance should have been called Don't Call Me, because it was... The first, like, two or three notes were just like...
It was like cats being thrown off a cliff. I thought that something was dying
Don't
somewhere.
Do that. We're not
no,
saying...
No, that's what I'm saying. Don't throw
versus
cats off a
clubbing seals and then throwing cats off cliffs.
No one's doing that.
No,
but that's what it sounded
don't.
Like. And that's why I got worried. I was about to call the SPCA.
And it got worse. It got progressively worse. And the even worse thing was that the judges were kind of being mean, but in a nice way. They were like, that wasn't the best one. And then Jennifer Lopez gives the worst judge ever. She says, I don't want to say anything bad because I don't want any more girls to go home. And I said, well, it doesn't matter if she's a girl or not. Just if someone's bad, they're bad. It doesn't matter if they're a boy,
well,
a girl,
because
honestly, alien.
Haley should have been gone weeks ago.
Yes.
In my opinion.
Yes.
I mean, she should have been gone weeks ago. It's kind of weird because you have Lauren Alana, who I think is very strong, and Haley is the other female who's just not strong. And, like, I'm sorry, Pia was better. I think Naima was better than
Pia. Oh, Naima was better.
You know, and, like, Thea, depending on what song Thea was going to sing, I thought Thea was be better than Haley, too. So, I mean, I don't know. I'm not. I hope she goes home, but I don't think she is. I think this is where American Idol works.
We can hope, but I think she'll be in the bottom three.
She better be, otherwise. I'm still going to have to watch it.
So should we switch gears here?
Let's talk about the boys and the good things.
Yes.
Like?
Casey
Abrams!
Whoa, it's an exclamation point.
Exclamation point. Casey, exclamation
point. And
it's purple. No, it's like pink. It's like, I don't know what color. I don't know what color
it
is.
He chopped his head off. Well, but anyway, he shaved a bit.
I didn't like that. He kind of looked creepy. He kind of looked creepy last night.
No, I thought it was, you know, clean. But who am I to talk?
I know you need to shave.
I'm going to.
You're frightening our viewers.
Well, next week I'm going to bring the stand-up bass.
Oh my God, would you? That would actually be right.
It's going to be horrible because I don't
know.
How to play.
You know, we actually can get one. I know someone in the newsroom who has one.
Awesome.
You think I'm joking? I'm going to make this happen.
Well, another thing with Casey, he started sort of a trend of the night, which was, I'm not going to listen to Jimmy Iovine.
Which isn't a bad thing. Well, he did Nature Boy.
Yeah.
And that King Cole song, because they say he was doing that King Cole, and I'm thinking, what Nat King Cole songs in a movie? And I'm like, was Unforgettable and something? And I was like, and who picks Nat King Cole on movie night? And then they did Nature Boy.
Yeah. Which, it was from a few movies. But then as I noted in my blog, which I thought was funny, was... that song was a jazzy take on it, was in one of Jennifer Lopez's movies.
Angel Eyes.
Yes, which no one saw.
No, but I read in the blog last
Wasn't
night.
Jesus in that movie, too?
Who?
The guy who played Jesus.
Jim Caviezel?
Yeah, I think he was in it, too.
I was like, what are you talking about? I was like, the Messiah came back to Earth to star in a J-Lo movie?
That was made in Manhattan.
Oh, Tim.
No offense.
Oh, Tim. So anyway... so he's saying Angel Eyes, or I'm sorry, Nature Boy,
yes.
Which was in Angel Eyes, and it was kind of, it was strange.
I liked it.
I didn't dislike it. I didn't love it, okay, because they gave him a standing ovation.
Yes. He was the only person to get one from the judges.
Well, in the crowd.
Well, the crowd gave one.
The crowd stands up and claps for anything. But,
they do that when Ryan Seacrest comes out, so what does that tell you?
Seacrest, by the way, speaking of Casey, Cafe Aroma and IOL got a shout out last night. I guess someone from Cafe Aroma called Ryan Seacrest on the show and they talked about it because they all get together. Bob Pratt, our Hemet columnist, actually wrote about a gathering up there because every week they watch Casey on American Idol and there's like the Casey Abrams Lounge.
And they wear sexy Casey shirts.
Yeah, that was something.
Yeah.
Because remember, that's what although I feel like he's getting away from that. Like, that's not the Casey we saw last night. Because, you know, you brought up, like, he was arguing with Jimmy, saying he wanted to be who he was as an artist. And I think he made the right choice, because I don't think you should sing a Phil Collins song on purpose. If you're going to sing...
Unless you're going to do it on accident?
No. I think the only one acceptable is Against All Odds. If you're going to... And that was in a movie called Against All Odds. Yeah, you know when he could have actually done that? Now that I thought, why didn't you think about that, Jimmy? Why didn't you give him that advice? But I actually...
Jimmy doesn't give good advice. Thank God Will I Am was there.
I know. Who would have thought we'd ever say that?
Yeah. I liked it, though, so I... You know,
I mean, I liked it, but he wasn't my favorite of the night.
So let's talk about, I think, potentially one of your favorites. As soon as I saw...
Oh, I thought we were talking about somebody else next, and I'm like, that person's not my favorite. What are you talking about?
Well, the reason I bring him up is because he had some help on stage that I thought would freak you out. So,
well, I mean, I'm not a huge Zakk Wylde fan. But
yeah,
Okay, let me just tell you. Let me say this. James Durbin did Heavy Metal from the film Heavy Metal, sung by Sammy Hagar from Fontana.
Yes.
This was the IE performance because it was all about the metal. And as we know, Big Four coming up next week, they're all about the metal here. Sammy Hagar.
Where can they find information about the Big Four Festival?
The Eye Guide. www.inlandsocal.com/eyeguide.
I had to, I'm sorry.
Well, no, and you can, because I am Metallica. But that's going to happen next week. It was like the moment of my life. Seriously. So James, like, and he's like totally like, and he told America, give heavy metal a chance. And I'm like, I hope the IU is watching. We're going to vote for you.
Even he's making patches, apparently.
I want one in armbands. And I'm like, dude, I've been rocking. We've been supporting the heavy metal all along.
How about that bandana that hangs from his pants?
His tail?
Yeah, you want one of those?
No. I want a patch.
Okay.
You know what? I would like, I want a heavy metal merit badge. Like, I would like to be like a heavy metal Girl Scout. Because I'm supporting the metal. Anyway, so Randy says, like, because he does it. He does scream. Some people
he goes
upset.
Full out, James. Like,
he does.
Full
and,
James Turbin.
Oh, and I mean, Jimmy hears a song like that, and he's like, what is that? That's not the hook. That's terrible. But he was very, I thought he was respectful, but stood his ground arguing with Jimmy.
Well, and that brought up a good story that Will I Am told about how he had basically the same conversation with Jimmy Iovine, and look what happened. Jimmy Iovine's like, you can't do a dance record, and that's probably the worst advice you can give to Black Eyed Peas. So, you shouldn't do a dance record. Oh, okay, we'll just sing ballads.
So, yeah, that would have been weird. But, yeah. I mean, James made his case, and, you know, and I think that's the thing. Like, everyone who changed their song, well, I think for James and for Casey, they made decisions for them who they want to be as an artist. Because J-Lo even said it last night. She was like, you know, we have a heavy metal idol. We have a jazz idol. We have a pop idol. I mean, he's going to be a name in heavy metal. Now, I don't agree with Randy. Randy's like, he could be on Ozfest. And I'm like, no, that's not really with the Ozfest crowd. But I think
you never know.
No, I've covered Ozfest. He's unless he starts going darker, which I don't think he can do on American.
Isn't his original stuff darker, though, from what I've heard?
I haven't heard his original stuff. Maybe he will be on Ozfest. And then we'll be here in DeVore. We'll talk to him then. But I mean, I think I'm, as a big heavy metal person, stop mocking how I keep hitting the chair. But I mean, as a big heavy metal fan myself, I am ecstatic that someone is bringing like Sammy Hagar and Judas Priest to the American Idol stage. And I can only hope, we need to Bon Jovi, which isn't really metal, but I love Bon
Close
Jovi.
Enough. Yeah.
I really, really, really hope that he takes on Metallica because I think that would be a really big challenge. I think you could do Nothing Else Matters. That's my pick. I'm just saying.
Okay, put it out there.
Your thoughts? You like James.
It was okay. Not enough to make me want to sing.
I'm sorry, wasn't he number 2 in your ranking?
Yes, but that's because no one else was really good.
Speaking of people who weren't really good, Stefano.
Well, he was kind of middle of the
Stefano's
pack.
Stefano's not on there yet. Stefano.
Stefano, where are you? Okay, well, Stefano will be here in a minute. There he is. Woo, Stefano.
Woo, Stefano.
Oh, Stefano, he's basically been renting out space in the bottom three for a couple weeks now.
I think the whole
he's moved all his stuff in, so he...
Yeah, he's like over there on that couch. He just doesn't even... I think if he was even safe, he wouldn't know to go to like the safe couch. He'd just be like, no, this is where I live. So. He sang End of the Road by Boyz II Men from Boomerang. Okay, number one, did anybody else notice that Randy Jackson last night looked like he was a member of Boyz II Men?
Yes.
Okay, awesome.
I thought he was going to start singing Motown Philly or something.
Why didn't he sing Motown Philly? I'm sure that was in a movie. That song's awesome. Doing a little East Coast. Mm-hmm. Boyz II Men going on. And actually, this is like my least favorite Boyz II Men song, but you brought up a, like, where you had me cracking up on the blog. I want to hear the story about your prom where they apparently only played Boyz II Men songs.
Okay, so my prom was like the worst thing ever. Like, we got there late. Everyone got food poisoning. People were smoking pot on the boat, so they made it like us all get off the boat. It was just the worst thing possible. And I think the DJ lost all of the CDs he brought, and all he had was a Boyz II Men one CD, because that's all they played the whole night. It was like on a loop. So you just knew like, oh, here comes End of the Road.
Wow. Wow. And no one's still bitter about this.
I did I danced once just because I was like, oh, I'm serious. Because like... The senior song was Boyz II Men. Everything was just Boyz II Men. So I was like, please stop. So I love Boyz II Men.
They just played here.
Yeah, they just played here. They're great guys. They're great
singers. They're great. They've never talked to us.
They're great singers.
They are incredibly talented.
I just don't want to hear their music anymore.
Stefano. Not a great singer last night. Not as bad. But
he was very middle of the pack for me. He wasn't the worst, but he wasn't anything special. He does the same things over and over again, where he takes
he's so corny.
Yeah, and what another thing I don't like about him is he had this, you know, this sob story where he was in a drunk driver hit him and he was, you know, gonna die. He has all these scars, and you're like, oh, that's such a great story. And then you find out a year later he was arrested for drunk driving.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Well, see, this is why you do the background research. But yeah, he was meh. I have nothing else to say about him. Let's move on.
Yeah, let's go on to
Jacob
Lusk.
Okay, you and I have differing opinions on this. Go ahead.
I've liked Jacob. I liked when he did Heart Alone.
Because you like Heart
a
lot.
I love that song.
That's why I feel
but
like
I just
you're biased.
Think week after week, it's just kind of the same.
Well, because he's gospel idol. That's what J-Lo said.
Yeah, but you can mix it up a bit. And I think...
What do you mix up? What is going to work for his voice?
He could do a low-key one without shrieking. You know, he doesn't have to...
I didn't think he was super shrieky last night.
But he shouldn't... He doesn't have to do that at all.
I liked it. I thought I got goosebumps hearing him sing last night.
Okay, well...
He did Bridge Over Troubled Water from Simon and Garfunkel, which I never knew. I couldn't think of what movie it was in. And they're like, The Pursuit of Happiness with Will Smith. And I'm like,
oh. Yeah, that... Yeah.
But no, he's one where recorded Jimmy... 20 years he listened earlier. To Jimmy. Jimmy was like, yes. Change your song. What was the first song he was singing? I don't even remember.
No.
What it was.
I don't either.
This was better.
But the great thing is Jimmy Iovine actually lectured him on don't tell
you
America
sold the record
off.
Yet. Yeah. Don't tell America off. Because last week he was all like, but you know what? He never really apologized. Like, I would think, like, in his time in front of the camera, he'd be like, yeah, he's like, I just hope you vote for me. You know, I just really want this. But I didn't get that from him. And I'm kind of like, I'm so mad from last week when you told me that if I didn't vote for you and you were in the bottom, it's because I couldn't look myself in the mirror. I mean, I hold a grudge, though.
It's true, though. I haven't been able to look myself in the mirror because I didn't vote for him. So.
Really?
Yeah.
But we don't vote for anybody.
That's true.
That would take us out of being impartial.
That's very true. Observers. I voted for Dave Zink, but... The number was down for some reason.
Yeah, I tried to call. It was like 1-866-555-ZINC, and it didn't work. So, yeah. So
two more. Let's just
get it through.
Yeah. So
I don't remember who else we have to talk
Scotty.
About.
Scotty. Hi, Scotty. Wait.
Scotty.
You know it's true.
That was pretty good. Oh, my God. You could be a Scotty McCreary.
So I guessed that he was going to sing a song from Pure Country.
Oh, my God. Yeah. High five.
Just because I would think, what's the one country movie I know for sure that's not country strong?
Wasn't there, well, I mean, Pure the country. Cowboy Way, I think, had some country music in it. Oh, and he could have done something from Walk the Line for crying out loud, sing Johnny Cash.
Yeah, but I know Scotty. I'm in his head.
That's frightening.
I got the Elvis thing right.
What song would you have sung from a movie?
I
would have sung something from Less Than Zero because I just watched it.
I would have sung something from High School Musical 3.
No, I know what you would have sung. We could have done a duet, Nothing's Gonna Stop Us Now from Starship. From the great film, Mannequin.
I wanted Casey to sing that.
I know you wanted to. I wanted him to sing it.
So, with Scotty...
It's the same thing. I don't think there's anything to say about it.
If you've watched the past few weeks, you've seen the same thing.
If you watched the entire show...
He didn't try, so I really didn't. Last night, I just kind of watched it, and I put the laptop down, and I was like, okay.
Yeah, it's like you sing the same thing. I hope next week's theme is better.
Disco.
Okay, because they're yelling at some people for knocking out of their Zoom, but they're like, well, you're great, Scotty.
Yeah, it's the double standards here.
I know.
Okay, last and certainly least.
Oh, that's not Scotty. It's Paul.
Paul.
I love
him. Okay, so imagine this suit, but in black.
I love him. Even my husband, like, walked by and was like, he's dreamy. I think he was mocking me, but he was like, he's dreamy.
Not the best song choice for him.
Oh, God, that was terrible. Okay, so he did Bob Seger.
Yeah.
Time of Rock and Roll.
Yeah.
Very iconic song.
Risky Business.
Risky Business.
Underwear. Sliding across the floor.
Sliding across the floor. So he walks down the steps in a full suit and does not a weaker thing. His voice is just not there. Like,
suited
actually, you know who I think could have done this song better? Durbin, James Durbin.
Oh, yeah. Because Durbin would have gotten his underwear and slid out.
Well, I mean, not the underwear part, but, like, as far as, like, the power of passion, like, it was strange. Like, everything, like, I just feel like, and again, I say this every week, none of these songs fit his voice.
Could we just have a Jack Johnson week and he'll be perfectly fine?
No, he's got more of a countryside. Like, I want to hear him doing more Ryan Adams-ish stuff. Not Ryan Adams. Like, I don't want to hear him doing other people's songs. I want to hear his original music.
Won't he be able to do that if he reaches the finals?
Well, Pia got a record deal last week, so kick him off America this week so he can get a record deal, and then I can listen to his original music.
Okay, so we get to the rankings then?
Yeah.
Top three, bottom three.
I don't even know where to go with this. I guess top three, I liked Lauren Elena, and I liked James Durbin.
Yes.
And I like Jacob Lusk with Casey in a close fourth.
That's mine's, I like Casey, James, and Lauren. Bottom three are Haley, Paul, and... Good old Scotty.
Really? Scotty over Stefano?
Yep.
I'm going with Haley by far was the worst. Because at least Paul, while he was weird, I think he hit the notes in his weird Paul voice. But Paul's a close second, and behind him, Stefano.
Well, Haley is in a class by herself, so I'm sorry.
Should have kept Pia. Not that anyone's so bitter about that.
You're a nice person, I'm sure. And you're apparently dating Casey Abrams, so...
Mazel tov.
Yeah.
All right. That's another... That wraps it up for another week.
Yes.
This Week in American Idol. Check out all of our Coachella coverage online. P.com. Or you can go to blogs.p.com/music or the iGuide at inlandsocal.com/iGuide. Thanks for watching.
We need that on the screen so you can just
just point to that because sometimes I have to think of what it is.
Let's work on that.
We'll have your people talk to our people are the same people. We'll just talk to the web team about it.
Yeah.
Anyway, Tim, as always, thanks for being here.
It's the worst high five ever.
That was not the worst high five ever.